brothers and sisters, be at ease. We do not wish any more of our people hurt. I ask you this now, outsider. Are you willing to parley? Not with me. I have been sent to you on behalf of the Lady. She believes you may not be aware of everything you should be. She means you no harm, provided your willingness to parley in peace is an honest one. What would be the point? You have already proven your strength. We have no wish to anger you further. We would not let her. We will protect our Lady to our last breath. It may yet come to pass that you will kill the rest of us, but until then we will not chance her coming to harm. Swiftrunner did not think it would matter. The Lady disagrees, and since you have forced your way this far, we must acquiesce to her wishes. She is not Witherfang, but she can tell you of Witherfang if you ask. But first, you must agree to parley.
It wishes to speak to these creatures. What is the point? We've slaughtered our way this far. What's a bit further? Fine. Arguing with that logic will just give me a headache, I swear.
Follow me. But I warn you, if you break your promise and harm her, I will come back from the Fade itself to see you pay.
I bid you welcome, mortal. I am the Lady of the Forest.
Do not listen to him, Lady. He will betray you. We must attack him now.
Hush, Swiftrunner. Your urge for battle has only seen the death of the very ones you've been trying to save. Is that what you want?
No, my lady. Anything but that.
And the time has come to speak with this outsider, to set our rage aside. I apologize on Swiftrunner's behalf. He struggles with his nature. Truer words were never spoken. But few could claim the same as these creatures, that their very nature is a curse forced upon them. No doubt you have questions, mortal. There are things that Zathrian has not told you. It was Zathrian who created the curse that these creatures suffer. The same curse that Zathrian's own people now suffer. Centuries ago, when the Dalish first came to this land, a tribe of humans lived close to this forest. They sought to drive the Dalish away. Zathrian was a young man then. He had a son and daughter he loved greatly. And while out hunting, the human tribe captured them both.
The humans tortured the boy, killed him. The girl they raped and left for dead. The Dalish found her, but she learned later she was with child. She killed herself. Zathrian came to this ruin and summoned a terrible spirit, binding it to the body of a great wolf. So Witherfang came to me. Witherfang hunted the humans of the tribe. Many were killed, but others were cursed by his blood, becoming twisted and savage creatures.
Twisted and savage, just as Witherfang himself is.
So the Dalish leader misled us.
You're not surprised?
No, just trying to picture his little elf head squishing. Ah, there we go.
They were driven into the forest. When the human tribe finally left for good, their cursed brethren remained. Pitiful and mindless animals.
Until I found you, my lady. You gave me peace.
I showed Swiftrunner that there was another side to his bestial nature. I soothed his rage and his humanity emerged. And he brought others to me. They are still cursed, mortal. The bestial side of their nature cannot be denied, and this places them forever outside of the company of their people. We seek to end the curse. The crimes committed against Zathrian's children were grave, but they were committed centuries ago by those who are long dead. Word was sent to Zathrian every time the landships passed this way, asking him to come, but he has always ignored us. We will no longer be denied.
We spread the curse to his people, so he must end the curse to save them.
Please, mortal, you must go to him. Bring him here. If he sees these creatures, hears their plight, surely he will agree to end the curse. If Zathrian comes, I shall summon Witherfang. I possess that power. I also have the power to ensure Witherfang is never found. Tell Zathrian this. If he does not come, if he does not break the curse, he will never find Witherfang, and he will never cure his people. I believe there is. There must be.
If there is no way, then he dies. Then they all die.
Then we shall await your return. Outside of this chamber, the passage leading back to the surface has been opened for you. Return with Zathrian as soon as you can.
Ah, and here you are already. You have carved a safe path through the forest. Safe enough for me to follow, anyhow.
I don't like this one. Can we not simply crush its head?
He wishes to see if we did his work for him. Is that not why you were here now, sorcerer?
Do not call me that, witch. I am keeper of this clan, and have done what I must. Did you acquire the heart? You didn't. May I ask then, why are you leaving the ruin? There was no need. I knew you would find it, and I did not care to give you a history lesson about things that have no bearing on your purpose here. But it seems the spirit convinced you to act on her behalf. Might I inquire what she wants? To survive, I suspect. That is the common nature amongst all such creatures, the will to survive. You do understand that she actually is Witherfang? She is the powerful spirit of this ancient forest that I summoned long ago and bound in the body of the wolf. Her nature is that of the forest itself. Beautiful and terrible, serene and savage, maiden and beast. She is the Lady and Witherfang both, two sides of a single being. The curse came first from her. Those she afflicted with it mirrored her own nature, becoming savage beast as well as human. They attacked my clan, and they were the same savages then that they have ever been. They deserve to be wiped out and not defended. Come, I will accompany you back to the ruin. Let us go and speak to the spirit, and I will force her into Witherfang's form. He may then be slain and the heart taken. Even so, they are still the same worthless creatures that their ancestors were. They deserve nothing more than the misery they possess. This is not your battle, Grey Warden. Let us just take the heart and be done with it. You were not there. You did not see what they did to my son, to my daughter, and so many others. You are Dalish. You know how he must.